Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can refresh a Power BI dataset without a user. What? It's crazy talk. Let's find out how. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, refreshing a data set without a user. Adam, what are you talking about? Typically, your user or a named user will have the ownership of the data set and the reports. And from an enterprise production perspective, maybe you don't want that. You want flexibility. You want some automated process that's just going to take care of this. Maybe it's part of a continuous integration or continual deployment, so CI/CD. You've got some DevOps type operations. Maybe it's an embedded or you're an ISV. These are all scenarios where this may be useful for you. There is a way you can get this up and running, but there's a couple things you got to be aware of. So I'm going to walk you through what those steps are. So enough of all this talking. You know how we like to do it on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. The magic of this is we're going to use what's referred to as a service principle. To create that service principle, you have to get an app registration configured. This is done within side of Azure Active Directory. If you're not familiar with service principles or app registrations, take a look at this video where I talk all about it. I'm not going to walk through that in this video, so go look at the other one if you need to know how to actually set up the service principle. So I've already got one configured. I'm calling it Gateway Service. The different PowerShell commandlets that we're going to talk about, they take different IDs. So the app or client ID is one of them. Make note of that GUID or GUID, however you want to call it. The other thing you're going to need to get is this object ID from the managed application itself. So to get that, we got to click on this gateway service here for the managed app. Inside of there, you'll see this object ID. That is the other GUID identifier that we're going to need. And I'll call out where you're going to need that. So the app ID, client ID, and this object ID that's part of the managed application of that app registration. That was something that really caught me off guard, and I had to figure that one out. The other thing you're going to need is there's going to be a secret that's defined for this app registration. So you'll need to know what that secret is as well. So now let's head over to Power BI. Inside of Power BI, I've got a report in a data set. Right now, this is assigned to my user. So you can see right here, data set's been configured by my user account. We don't want that. We want it to be a service account. So there will be a couple things we have to do. The other thing I'm going to call out here, if we go to manage gateways, come down to the gateway that I'm using here, and we'll see that right now I'm the only user that's allowed to use this data source on the gateway. The other thing is I am the only administrator. Patrick is too, but we'll ignore that. The service principal is not listed as an admin here either. You can technically add the service principal as a user of the gateway. That would be important if you were automating adding the service principal to the data sources because they have to be an admin as well. Unfortunately, when we get to that step, the PowerShell commandlet will give you an error saying you can't do it with the service principal at the time of this recording. So hopefully that changes at some point. I'm going to skip the step of adding the service principal as an admin of the gateway, although it is possible. So going back to the data set itself, that service principal needs to be the owner of the data set. To do that, we're going to use PowerShell. We're going to use the Power BI PowerShell commandlets. I'll have a link down in the description below to where you can go install those. In order to take over the data set, we have to be logged in with the user that we want to do the takeover for. So that means we have to log in with that service principal. So connect Power BI service account, you'll list your tenant ID or your directory ID because the service principal has to actually define that tenant ID. So you cannot skip this setting. And then you have to declare that you want to sign in with a service principal. And then for this purpose, I'm going to actually have a pop out to put in the app ID as well as the secret. I'm not using that object ID here. You can actually have a way to hard code that as well. I'm going to hit OK. And then I'm logged in with that client ID. The next thing you're going to need to do is get the IDs of the workspace and the data set in question. You can just do this from the URL. So if I go into the settings of the data set, the first GUID here after groups, that is the workspace or group ID. And then after data sets, we'll have the GUID for the actual data set itself. That's going to be used for the command. So make sure you have those listed out. And then I'm going to use the invoke Power BI REST method. So there's not actually a command in the PowerShell commandlets to take over the data set. There is a REST API. So I'm going to manually call that REST API API from the PowerShell commandlets because it just is a nice wrapper for all of it. And I'll have links to all of the REST APIs used down in the description below as well. So go check that out. In this case, we can see here default.takeover. That's part of the data set. That means I'm going to take ownership of the data set from my logged in credential, which in this case is the service principal. Let's go ahead and do that. Now I am an owner. So if I come back, let's refresh the page. I'm signed into the portal with my ASaxon account. So now you can see that the data set is configured by Gateway Service. It's actually owned by the service principal. I have the option of taking this back over, but at this point, it's good to go. Let's just go and refresh the data set. We're going to see an error here right away. So if we go back into the settings, we'll see that schedule refresh has been disabled. And if we look at details, it's because the data sources, they're missing credentials. So whenever you take over the data set, you have to reassign the credentials and or reassign it to a gateway data source. The challenge here is from a service principal perspective in the UI, you can't do that. So we can use PowerShell to actually do this and assign the data set to defined data sources in the gateway. Before we do that though, the service principal has to be in that user list of the data source and that user tab that I showed you before that only I'm listed in. So we got to use PowerShell to add that and configure the gateway first to allow that service principal to use them. Then we can come back and configure the data set. So what I'm talking about here is under this manage gateways, if we come down to the data source, the service principal has to be listed here in the user list. So again, let's use some PowerShell. I've got to use the data gateway PowerShell commandlets. This actually requires PowerShell 7. So you may have to install that as well. Again, links down in the description below. This is a command when I tried to do this with the service principal, it actually gives me an error saying you can't do that. So unfortunately, I've got to do that with an admin of the gateway. So I'm going to do this from my user account, not the service principal. Now, the beauty of this though, is you only have to do this one time. The admin of the gateway can set this up and then move on with your automated processes. So hopefully that's not that big of a deal. What you're going to need here is you're going to need the gateway cluster ID, and then you're going to also need the data source ID itself. You can get this from the UI if you want to get it that way. You can get it from PowerShell as well. If we go to the UI to the actual data source that we want to define, so in this case, my AdventureWorks data source, from the URL, you're going to see gateways. This GUID, this 27869, is the gateway cluster ID. And then the next GUID, this ACBE, is the data source GUID. So we've got that for AdventureWorks. We've got it for the subcategory data source. And then we've got it for our geography data source as well. So those GUIDs update. So that's how you can get those GUIDs. Again, you can also get it and list out those items from the PowerShell commandlet perspective as well. There's three data sources. So we got to do this three times. The first one I'm going to do is the AdventureWorks. We can see our 27869. That's our cluster ID. The other one is the data source ID. So that's that ACBE. The other ID you're going to see here is what's listed as identifier. This is that object ID I showed you in the Azure portal. So you got to make sure you've got the right identifier here. Otherwise, it'll give you an error and you'll be scratching your head for a while. That's how I lost my hair. So let's go and run this. That succeeded. And so the next thing we're going to do is our subcategory data source. That succeeded. And then the next one we're going to do is the geography data source. And that succeeded as well. So let's go back and verify in the portal. I'm just going to refresh the page. And if we go to the user list now, we see the gateway service is now listed under the users. The actual service principal now has rights to use that data source on the gateway. You won't be able to take advantage of single sign-on if that was something you were looking for because of the fact that the service principal is not an actual user, so it doesn't necessarily translate to anything on the data source. These data sources will have to use that hard-coded credential. Now what we need to do is come back and set the data source to go use those data sources in the gateway. Again, we can't use the UI here because we're not logged in as the service principal, and you can't log in with the service principal here to do this. So we've got to do it in PowerShell. I'm still signed in as my service principal, which is good because I'm the owner of that data set. And the command we're going to use is referred to as the bind data set to gateway. This is the bind to gateway in group REST API. Again, links down in the description below. You'll see that for the given data set, this is the default.bind to gateway. So we're binding the data set to the data sources in the gateway. And what you'll see here also is you're listing out the data source object IDs to bind. Those are the three data sources that we had before. We can see our gateway cluster ID here, and then the three data source IDs entities that are part of this. One thing to be aware of when I did this, I had to have all of them defined in the gateway itself. One of them is a web data source, so it doesn't actually require the gateway. You could potentially update the credentials for that through APIs as well. I haven't tried that with the service principal, so that may be something you want to explore to avoid having to go through the gateway for that. In this case, I've got all three going through the gateway, and it's just one easy command to go do that. It ran successfully. Come back to our page, refresh again. So this is our data set. Let's see if we can actually refresh at this point. It succeeded. And if we come back to refresh history, we can see the last one did complete as the service principal. So the service principal refreshed the actual data set using the gateway. So the service principal is listed as a user of that data source, and it was also the owner of the data set itself. The service principal completely did this refresh operation. That is awesome. All right, what do you think about that? I know there were a couple steps that you got to go do because you got to get the data set configured, you got to get the gateway configured, and then you got to bind those items back over, but it does work. Let me know in the comments below what you think. Is this something you're doing? Is this something that just blew your mind? You didn't even know this was possible? I want to hear it. Let me know. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.